We'll move on to the second presentation from engineer Charafat Afailal. Engineer Charafat has got an engineering background, and she's an expert in water and climate. She is a former minister in charge of water in Morocco. She significantly contributed to the reform of the water sector in Morocco. So I'm honored to invite Engineer Charafat for the presentation.
Good morning, everyone. I'm very happy to be with you today to take part to this important session and to discuss such an important topic about climate change and mitigation and adaptation in the water sector. Climate change affects water resources critically. The damage is devastating, causing the loss of human life and blocking development. The impact affects the vulnerable countries strongly, like Africa and the Sahel region also in the Africa. Facing climate change should start with water and finish with water. The water indeed must be both the starting point and the target in the same time. So why it is necessary to start with water? Water, first, the water is the main victim of climate change. Through water we can assess the acceleration of climate change, and through water we can find solution also. Secondly, over than 90% of climate change disasters are related to water. Drought, flooding, desertification, the sea level rise, etc. Then water is definitely the heart of humanity. It can reinforce or impair regional peace, stability, and solidarity around the world. Last but not least, the water is important, so important, and then the, not this one, sorry. The lack of it, could jeopardize the achievement of all the SDGs. All the SDGs are related to the water. If we don't have water, that means we won't achieve the SDGs. The 16 SDGs will be compromising. So, what have we done so far to solve the water issue within the climate change effect? To be honest, the International Committee has demonstrated a very little effort to solve the water issue comparing to the other sectors, just like the energy. We are now currently facing the alarming situation. We are living the alarming situation, and the future prediction and so more alarming. That could threaten the whole humanity. For every temperature degree, we will have there will be 20 degrees of water resources in many parts of the world. 1 to 2 billion people will be suffering from the water scarcity by 2050. Regions suffering from food and water insecurity will be strongly impacted, Sahel and Africa. Increase of natural disaster related to water as well. Despite this situation, we sense that the international commitment toward water still weak compared to that of the energy. Even if water is a key factor for both mitigation and adaptation efforts. What is the impact of climate change in the water sector? First, we have the economic impact. The uncertainty of the hydrological cycle without real data. All the management of the water sectors will be compromising. Water resources planning and infrastructure development requires accurate data. Under climate change uncertainty, the approach should be changed, and the decision makers should set up a flexible strategy which requires more funds to implement it. Second one, the climate change has started threatening the economic development in developing countries, which could compromise the achievement of all the SDGs. It has even started destroying infrastructure, causing the loss of human life. This picture illustrates the damage caused by the last flooding in Morocco in the summer. In the summer, we don't supposed to have rainfall in Morocco. The social impact we are observing right now, the increasing of water scarcity in many regions and food insecurity also in the vulnerable region. Now in the Africa, there are more than 330 million people who don't have access to water and more than 600 million who are still in the dark without access to electricity, only in Africa. Climate change reduced the water flow, of course, and that caused the deterioration of quality of water, which can increase and disseminate the waterborne diseases in many countries, just like cholera and other diseases, especially in the African countries. Last but not least, the enemy of the ecosystem is the climate change. This picture shows the effects of drought in Sous River in Morocco on the fish. All the fish are died in Morocco. So we can affect also all the ecosystem. Where shall we start? The right way to cope with climate change is to build a new mode of governance in the water sector. That means our aim is not to break away with the way what we manage water until now, but we should reinforce and revise all the policies and the strategy to adapt it in the new context. Here we have a Moroccan concept to manage the climate change in the desert area, in the south part of Morocco, which lead to promising results. The core of this concept relies on increasing building resilience, and what that means, we should embrace the positive impact and manage the risk related water in this area, which not very often have the regular rain. We have only rain one time in each 4 years. The adaptation effort and mitigation policies is based on three pillars. Putting the adaptation and mitigation measures, building resilience and taking advantage of climate change impact to compensate the water deficit in this arid region, and managing as well the risk of climate change by reducing the negative impact. The adaptation and mitigation policies include different mechanisms and plans, in particular flooding protection plan, mobilizing the flood of water, drought management plan, and as well risk management system that is irrigated as national priority. We manage the risk as a national priority in this region. For the flooding protection plan, we are setting an alarming system to warn local population and authorities along the main rivers for emergency measures that could be evacuation of the population in case of dangers. The mass of the equipment is functioning with solar energy so that we can combine with mitigation and adaptation efforts. This is the network of measuring around the main rivers. A flooding protection work as well to correct the endangered area to protect the population and the private and public facilities and amenities. The second pillar is one way to turn the situation to local community advantages is to set up just like trash hold along the river to maximize the time of infiltration to recharge the aquifer in this region and take advantage with water for the agriculture, for other activities. And as well, we are accelerating investment in the infrastructure by dam construction. And with that approach, we're showing a very, very, very conclusive result by the improvement of the level of situation of the population by minimizing also the rural exodus to the other parts of Morocco. And we are now in the progress to adapt this situation in other regions of Morocco. And of course, the last but not least, in the drought management, we are putting in place a system to assess and evaluate the level of drought in many regions. And when the red light is coming. We ask users to adapt this agriculture, to adapt this situation, and to reduce also the amount of water of any water resources in this region. This is what I want to share with you during the for to duplicate this concept in many other regions. Thank you so much.